good day, viewer. Welcome to the program Talking Politics, where we normally discuss the issues, the political development that has been happening in the country, as well as other political matters. I am Al Hassan Bala. Today we are going to discuss a lot of issues. Last week we discussed the issue of the Concorso Ganduje matter. About this week, because of what happened within the week, the issue of the adjustment, the proposed adjustment of the election timetable by House of Representatives, as well as the Obasanjo's letter to President Muhammadu Buhari, scoring him low, as well as asking him not to run for 2019 election again. I am Al Hassan Bala once again. But firstly, we are going to begin with the issue of the House of Representatives asking the or trying to adjust the election timetable by bringing the National Assembly National Assembly election first, leaving the Presidential Assembly will be the last election in 2019. Although the electoral umpire already released the timetable, which the presidential election will be the first election to be held on in the February 2019. But firstly, let's look at the reaction of our civil society organizations.
Using the instrumentality of legislation, this is where, however concerned about the delays in the passage of the amendments to the constitutional legal framework for the conduct of the 2019 elections, of particular concern are proposals coming from the National Assembly to amend the Electoral Act to alter the timetable for the 2019 elections already announced by the Independent National Electoral Commission. The proposal by the National Assembly to alter the order of elections already set by INEC is an unwarranted interference in the constitutional powers of INEC to determine the conduct of elections, and interferes with the powers of INEC to carry out its electoral duties without directives or control from any person or authority. Using the instrumentality of legislation, this is unacceptable and is hereby condemned. The National Assembly needs to backtrack from passing self-serving legislation that contradicts constitutional guarantees of the independence of INEC. Additionally, the National Assembly needs to backtrack from passing self-serving legislation that contradicts constitutional guarantees of independence of INEC.
Policy and Legal Advocacy Center, Dr. Clement Uwonko, asking the House of Representatives to backtrack the decision. And in the studio on this issue, I have a former House of Representative member and also a barrister, that is Barrister Ibrahim Bello. Welcome to the studio.
Well, thank you. Yes, good afternoon.
A lot of things concerning this issue of decision by the House of Representatives to actually adjust the election timetable barely 2 weeks after the National Electoral Independent National Electoral Commission released full timetable of the election. Firstly, being a former House of Rep member and also a legal practitioner, what is the legal implication to this?
Thank you very much. Viewers, good afternoon. It's my pleasure to be here once again to discuss this kind of a very important matter with so many Nigerians. Some are jubilating, but majority are not happy with, like, interference. You know, the National Assembly is trying to interfere the work of the INEC, which the INEC is an independent body, which if it's not saddled with independency, you know, of things of this nature, then even their work cannot be made easy for them. Well, it has to be clear here that the Independent National Commission, INEC, their sole responsibility give a framework of how election, you know, will be conducted. And at the National Assembly, in the other angle, from what's obtainable now, they have no right whatsoever to go into a situation whereby putting all the work, which most of people, the policy itself, people appreciate exactly the development of what has done today. Because in the other dispensations, you find out that you hardly know exactly even when election is taking place. But Nigerians, even we in polity, they're happy that now the INEC has given a reasonable time notice for the political parties, aspirants, the public, electorates, to get set about what is coming.
But quickly on the issue of the National Assembly decision or the House of Representatives decision to actually adjust the timetable, what are the legal implications?
They have no right to make that. It's just that whenever it comes to the National Assembly, way of motion or petition or any other members, the 360 members House of Reps, if there's issue that comes up, yeah, it must be deliberated. And unilaterally, we have bicameral parliament in Nigerian parliamentary system, whereby the House of Reps member, whatever that has been deliberated, has to concur with the 109 members of the Senate. So along the line, whatever is there, since it has not been resolved, there's not any permitted resolution. But all at the same time, the National Assembly cannot interfere with the ambit of the Nigerian constitution to satisfy their own frolic or whims. All I have to say here is they are deliberating upon a matter which is already is a responsibility of INEC, which is an interference, which didn't have the right to do it, but in there, it's a parliament. The resolution is said to be delivered, and there's another ambit of the parliament, the upper house, upper chamber, is watching. So there must be concurrence. So it's just that now Nigerians are confused, and Nigerians are not happy that, look, why is that INEC, they're doing their own legislative, they're doing their own constitutional or statutory responsibility. The National Assembly is trying to interfere, it's trying to cause a lot of confusion and commotion or distraction in their own activity. But all I have to tell the public now, they have to be patient. This matter is from the National Assembly, the House of Representatives, they make their kind of submission. The Senate must also give its own kind of resolution before it becomes whatever it is. But now at this angle, they have no right to tell them what to do. Because that's what makes INEC independent. They should have free hand from interference, from any legislative process which is invalid. If now the National Assembly was able to now distract the timetable, the framework which is submitted by the INEC to a particular date, which suits the National Assembly members, the danger is, if a date is fixed, then what is the question if there's a war or there's any problem in the country? So we don't want the National Assembly to intervene in something which is another angle with the agents that sell with themselves to do that. So all I know is that able to be cleared, because Nigerians are not happy with what is obtainable now, and the 360 members of the House of Reps, 109 members of the Senate, they all represent Nigerians. And this issue must be deliberated so that if a resolution is taking place, it's going to be such a president impeachment. So impeachment, not any flimsy legislative process will be made to corner or to put any political intrigue in the interference of the INEC so that they can have smooth running of responsibility. Now, National Assembly is stronger than the INEC, so that's why we don't expect disputes. We expect compliance and proper legislative processes, which I believe must be conducted, and let the public be patient enough to listen to what the House of what the Senate will now come with is finally resolved.
Okay, still on the issue of political happenings, this week the former president, let us go back now to the issue of the former president Olusegun Obasanjo. You are an APC member and a very strong supporter of the of President Muhammadu Buhari.
Yes.
How do you receive the letter by former President Obasanjo to President Muhammadu Buhari?
Every Nigerian has the right to express his opinion about any government policy or governance, whether you're a councillor, a member of assembly, a House of Reps member, a senator or governor, whoever you are. So our ex-president, Olusegun Obasanjo, is a Nigerian. He has the right to his own observation. He has the right to make his own kind of submission. But the only thing, one, is that he has no right to direct somebody on that person's fundamental rights. That's what's called encroachment, impringement. He has the right, you know, as an advisory capacity, as a colleague or a statesman, like the incumbent president. But for you to come out and say this particular person should not, you don't have that right, because President Muhammadu Buhari is having first term in office, and constitutionally we have a 4-year single terms in office. So after these 4 years, President Muhammadu Buhari is eligible enough to expire for another 4-year term. If Nigerians voted him, fine. But it's just that he cannot go for the third time. So for somebody in Nigeria to come upon you and violate your own fundamental right is very, very unfortunate. So we found out that, and even the former president, Olusegun Obasanjo, should apologize to him. But in other aspects, his own observation, as a former Nigerian president, he has the right to say there's a credit in terms of security challenge.
But when the same Obasanjo wrote a letter to Goodluck Jonathan, people commended him. But now it seems like people are condemning him. What actually happened? Is it because Buhari has what?
No. President Muhammadu Buhari is unique. He's a different person.
Everybody is unique.
President Muhammadu Buhari, in this governance, we inherited a lot of issues from the other, from our predecessors.
But people say he's too slow.
No, nobody says he's too slow.
He said he don't take action hurriedly.
Do you want you to hurry up so that he be subject to ridicule and impeachment?
Even on the issue of security?
He has taken measures, because every Nigerian knows that there's a security integration now. It's not how we got this government. It's not how we have started. Every Nigerian knows that there's a lot of security, you know, better than what has been obtainable.
Even when his wife is criticizing him on the issue of appointment?
Yes, even if the wife does not have any statutory powers to challenge about any appointment, she doesn't have. The wife has the right to her own opinion, her own observation, but she doesn't have any mandate. It's just she can be any other woman in this country. She has, as I've said before, every Nigerian has an absolute right to make observation about the governance of the police or any governance or what have you. You have the right, but the only thing is that you should just know what to say, responsibly and reasonably. So, but if a woman, if a Mr. President's wife come out and said, look, this is my observation, this is how I want my husband to do, he has that discretion. Is she elected? Does she have any public mandate? Is she just a president's wife? There's not any prohibition of Mrs. The First Lady in any of our laws.
But don't forget, up to now, 50% of appointees have the past administration appointees.
Yes, you see, when you're talking about appointments, it's gradual. Nigerians were mean people. We want things to happen instantly. We want things to happen summarily. A Nigerian wants things to happen today. So, and President Muhammadu Buhari is the kind of person that he wants to do things gradually, gently, with perfection and caution. So, some of Nigerians,
Is that the reason why that he cannot reshuffle his cabinet?
Because the power,
despite the fact that a lot of allegations are there.
All the allegations are frivolous. Why is justification? And why is the law that mandated that Buhari must reshuffle the cabinet today or tomorrow?
Was it the reason why that the President Muhammadu Buhari cannot ask EFCC to arrest SGF almost 6 months after?
President Muhammadu Buhari is not the one to ask the EFCC to arrest former SGF.
After all the allegations?
When you say allegation, it's not something that has been justified. When you want to make allegation to be justified, let it be taken to court of law. No, any policeman can justify an allegation. The whole bust up is the court of law of this country. So, we don't want petition talk. People are in political arena. Somebody, they don't even know the legal implication of what they're saying. All they want is just to talk anything that comes from their mouth. President Muhammadu Buhari comes from the executive as of government. The police, as a department, they don't come from the judiciary ambit of the government. So now he has done his own. After prop, there's a lot of committee fact finding, and he has taken decision. So he cannot operate for any EFCC. He cannot operate for any court of law. He cannot give any warrant of apprehension of this former SGM. A tree cannot make a forest. He has to maintain his own social responsibilities. This is another arms of the government that will do their own kind of social responsibilities. So if you now want to look at Buhari, he's the one to arrest Babacheri, he's the one to pursue Babacheri, you're not going to be fair to Muhammadu Buhari. What are the remaining half of government doing? So you mean Buhari being the executive president of this country to start looking for people to arrest him, to take him to court for prosecution? No.
But the same Buhari government is holding El-Zazaki, is holding Dasuki, is holding a lot of people there.
You see, whenever you want to make the kind of submission, I will appreciate when you make a formidable justification. When you say somebody holds somebody, justify it. In law, the law is straightforward, it's constitutional. Every accused person presumed to be innocent until the contrary is established against him. And we have three arms of government. The Mr. President comes from the executive arms of government. We have legislators. Sadly, we're supposed to make a lot of this country. We have the judiciary, they are not politicians. These people are determining whether the person is guilty or not. So now, if you mixed up, that's where the problem comes. So sometimes because of politics, there's a lot of allegations from one angle to another against Mr. President. So people should be aware about the sensibilities of what a Mr. President can do or not to do.
All right, thank you very much, Honorable Ibrahim Bello, who has been former House of Representative members representing from Kaduna State and also an APC member right from the CPC era. A lot of things we discuss, issue of INEC and National Assembly issue, as well as Obasanjo letter to Buhari. And we are going for break. When we return, we shall be discussing still issue of Obasanjo letter to President Muhammadu Buhari with another APC chieftain, Honorable Usman Ibrahim.
Love is a verb. Show that special someone just how much they mean to you. Need some help? Aha! ITV Reignite the Flame Season 2 is your best bet. There will be games, comedy, music, and an ambience that says, "You mean the world to me." It is quality time guaranteed with loads of fun at Beehives Hotel, Saitag Villa, Gwarimpa, Abuja. Date, Wednesday, 14 February 2018. Time, 5 p.m. prompt. For tickets and reservations, call 080-6622-6093 or 070-671-57865. ITV Valentine Dinner, reignite the flames. Like the sun was made to shine and the moon
was made for night. Independent television is live 24 hours on GoTV, channel 107, Star Times, channel 130. And now you can watch from any part of the world on Roku TV, Smart TV, Amazon Fire TV, and Android TV for your favorite programs, news, current affairs, and lots more. You don't want to miss our objective and balanced reportage, entertainment, and sport. Watch ITV via live streaming on the internet, itvradionigeria.com/live.
Welcome back. Still, you are watching the program Talking Politics, and we are discussing the issue of Obasanjo's letter to President Muhammadu Buhari, asking him not to run. And in this segment, we have another FEC chieftain and national coordinator of Muhammadu Buhari Oshinbanjo campaign organization, a dynamic organization and or support group. And we are going to discuss that issue with him. And is Honorable Usman Ibrahim. Welcome to the studio.
Thank you very much.
Honorable, a lot of things happened within this week, ranging from the issue of the letter to President Muhammadu Buhari, that even activists were divided, legal practitioners were divided, and other commentators. Firstly, being the national coordinator of Muhammadu Buhari Oshinbanjo Dynamic Support Group, how do you receive that letter?
Thank you very much. My brother, it is politics. And when we call politics, it's politics, then I think we should leave it at that level. If you could remember, President Obasanjo himself, he says that he's entitled to his own opinion, entitled to his right. And I think he expressed his right at that particular issue now. So I think why people are taking matter as if it's a thing of a serious, not a serious thing. Since he said it, he admitted his mistake. So I think let's leave it at that level.
So do you think Buhari should not recontest?
Buhari will contest. Nothing will stop Buhari not to contest.
But there are a lot of issues raised, Renjo, from based on the former president's submission that the administration has scored low in so many sectors, then the issue of he's yet to even reshuffle his cabinet despite a lot of things. What will you say on that?
You see, reshuffling his cabinet on issue of that nature. First and foremost, let's go back to the history. If you look at things when Buhari took over, what was the country is all about that then? Let us speak from our heart. We should be good citizens enough to judge, you know, apart from sentiment. He made an empty treasury, a looted like an armed robbers invaded a bank. That's how Nigeria was. We've forgotten, all of us were witnesses, and it's not even long, just 2 years ago. And Buhari is trying to keep things to put the structure, solidify the structure in the first place. That's what Nigeria is lacking. I think I don't think there's any sentiment in it.
But a lot of issues are there, more especially when it comes to the appointment by President Muhammadu Buhari, which even the members of his political party, that is APC,
yes,
in the National Assembly,
yes,
actually criticizing him, including his own wife.
Yes.
What will you say on that? Because when you look at the appointment, people are saying that he always appointed people from his side, that is from the northern part of the country, leaving the southern part of the country with nothing.
You are another like me, if that should be the case. Who and who did you see? Those are prerogative of the president. It's the constitutional mandate. He can take anybody he wants to take.
But it's supposed to have actually accommodate everybody. So
and
that
you say, yes,
you are talking
I
about
agree on that. You cannot employ somebody, and at the same time, you can't pay him. The time he made of an empty treasury, where will he get the money? Will he go and borrow money in order to satisfy people like that? Democracy is about people to affirm somebody and trust person. Buhari, a common man from me and you, we trust him. He's not a thief. So we trust him, give him that trust. And we're sick and tired of all this type of attitude with the first leaders, those looters. We will not accommodate them. Buhari will be there. We'll solidate. And then Buhari also, coupled with his deputy, a trustworthy man, a professor of that matter. Let us see, Nigerian, that this country, we will never be given like a child in hands of mad people. This one will pull this
what
one.
What I'm
no
talking
more
about is appointment. Most of his appointment are from the northern part of the country.
Where did you quantify it? Who and whom? Is it not his aide? Is it not the aide that works with him?
Okay. Let's look at the security.
Yes.
The head of the security agencies.
Yes.
Where are they from? Most of them.
It's also the constitutional mandate to the president. If he lies, he can appoint anybody. You don't have any reason for him to question him about those people who he trusts them.
Does that mean he's not accommodative?
He is. He's accommodative. Very much accommodative. Very much. Those people who choose, he chose them. I could quote even our national party. There was a time in 2015, Ali, we visited him when people raised the same questions. He said, yes, Buhari has the right to choose the people that he trusts. And he chose those people around him with trust. And up to the moment, now, I think we're almost in three years now, not just point one that has made mistakes among the people he appointed.
Well, time is not by our side.
The time should be on our side. Let's call it spade a spade. Those people he trusts, he knows them from in and out. And
he
doesn't
know anybody from southern part of the country.
The southern part of the country, whatever, all we need is Nigeria. And when the structure is functioning very well, then it goes to everywhere. We will not make Nigeria like a cake you keep, and this one will cut and eat. No, that is by gun. And let me tell you, wallahi, whether they like it or not, Buhari will contest, and will win.
That is your position.
Including you, including the rest of people behind us. Because the truth of the matter is, we have found somebody that we will always be with him.
Okay,
we
thank
trust
you.
Him. He's not a thief.
Thank you very much, Honorable Usman Ibrahim, for discussing with you. I hope that next week we are going to have you and discuss other issues, ranging from national issues in the political happenings in the country. You have been watching Talking Politics on ITV, and that's much we have for today because of time. Until next week, we are going to discuss a lot of political happenings, issue of PDP, have reconciliation, reconciliation matters, that is the post-convention crisis. I am Al-Hassan Bala. See you then.
Thank you.